We are the Southeastern Massachusetts Wind Symphony, a wonderful collaboration with the Smarts Collaborative, better known as the Southeastern Massachusetts Arts Collaborative, and the Wheaton College wind players and brass players and percussion players, along with some very talented high school students that have joined us as well over the years to play with our group. We open with a piece by John Philip Sousa called With Pleasure, because that's what this evening will be for us. We love to get together on Thursday evenings, right? And just have a great time making music and exploring all sorts of different types of music. We open with John Philip Sousa's piece that he wrote for his 1912 world tour, a bit of ragtime. We think of Sousa as a march king, but he actually wrote in many other styles, including opera selections. This is ragtime music, and he opened every concert on that world tour in 1912. So that takes us back a little bit, and I think it's a great way to start our program. Next, we're going to turn to a piece by the British composer John Rutter. I had the opportunity to play with him under his baton at Carnegie Hall quite a number of times, and I would always, as a conductor myself, try to get along with him and ask him some questions. And one day I asked him how he came up with his melodies for his compositions, and he said, "I'm a thieving magpie. I'm just like that bird. I go around and I listen to this, I listen to that, and I steal whatever I like, and I build my own little musical nest with it." This is a beautiful rendition of the hymn For the Beauty of the Earth. I thought it would be a lovely way to kick off our spring season, and this is just absolutely delightful. John Rutter's For the Beauty of the Earth. four folk songs from the Isle of Man, a little island in the Irish Sea. And this is really absolutely stunning music. I want to point out that this piece is the longest one in the program, and it does go on for quite a while. No, it's not 50 minutes long. It's not 30 minutes long. It's a mere 25. No, it's not even that. It's 10 minutes long. 10 minutes long. But I think it's a good place to put it in the program. I think you'll enjoy it very much. There are all sorts of sprightly melodies towards the middle, but at the beginning we have this lovely, lovely romantic melody that features the clarinet section.
Thank you.
famous bolero. Certainly in the Spanish dance form, there's a great story about someone attending one of his concerts where this piece was first premiered. It was originally meant to be for a ballet. It's a one-movement piece. Now, someone came to this performance, and at the end, when the wild sounds of the trombone glissandos were playing, this person said, "Ravel, you are absolutely insane. You are mad. You're out of your mind." And he said, "Finally, somebody understands who I am and what this piece is really about." It's supposed to be a frantic, just a frantic dance that builds and builds, but in a very restrained, exciting way. Now, the arrangement that we're playing is really for the children in the audience, because bolero is a pretty long work, and I'll tell you, some musicians just don't like this piece because it is one long crescendo. It starts soft, and it gets louder, and it gets louder, and it gets louder, until it's just, you know, just insane at the end. However, there are beautiful themes in this, and the audience always enjoys it. We just thought it would be nice for some of the kids that are in the audience to get a chance to hear this piece. So we're not doing the entire piece. We sort of cut it down just a little bit. How many children do we have in the audience? Would you raise your hands?
Raise your hands.
Now, if you're a child under the age of 15, would you give up? Woo!
Woo!
If you're a child under the age of 10, would you give up? Years old, would you just give a blood-curdling scream? Okay, so here we go with Lara.
Thank you.
piece that needs no introduction. All of these wonderful, wonderful themes that you know and love by Bizet.
Thank you. Thank you.
stage, and I suddenly said, where's my music? Where are my keys? So I'm walking up and down the hallways looking for my keys, and I go in the back to see if she has a master key, and then I remember I set my keys back in the sound room. So I'm so sorry about that. I'll never let it happen anymore.
Thank you.
We're going to change the order up a little bit right now and do a piece by Leroy Anderson, the great writer for the Boston Pops Orchestra. Anderson was already writing some wonderful novelty pieces, pieces that we would sort of call encore pieces when he was discovered by Arthur Fiedler. And soon he was writing for the Boston Pops, and the rest is history. He would have these little quirky, fun pieces where he would use everything from typewriters to bells that you would ring on a counter for service, the sleigh bells. This particular piece is his version of a tango also, blue tango. Now these last pieces to end our program sort of take us through a development of jazz music in many, many ways. We start off first with an African-American spiritual, My Lord, What a Morning. And this particular arrangement uses some African drumming in the middle section, but it starts to bring us into rhythms that will later be used in rock and roll and certainly in the blues and jazz. That will take us into the St. Louis Blues, great, just a great blues tune. And then we'll finish out with some Rampart Street Parade. We've really enjoyed playing for you tonight. If you know somebody who plays an instrument well and would like to be a part of this experience, please tell them about our group. We have people that come from far away, as far as the Cape, and as far as beyond Worcester, going on north and west. So this is really an ensemble that brings people of all ages and many different regions together to make some great music. And we love for your friends, or maybe even you, if you're that person, to be a part of our ensemble. So thanks again for coming out on a Thursday evening. We hope you'll be coming again. We'll be really back in December. That's the next concert that we have for you. So the next time we see each other, it'll be cold and snow on the ground. Let's look forward to that, shall we? Okay, here we go with The Fantasy of an African American Spiritual. My Lord, what a morning. not make the people playing it feel better. It should make everyone listening feel just a little bit worse. So let yourself go. Just imagine, think about Monday morning. You know, Friday is tomorrow, but think about the weekend's going to be beautiful, and then Monday morning we're back to the same old stuff. And let yourself go there. He retired, so he doesn't care. You're good, everything's great. Now listen, just let yourself go there, and you'll sink down into despair, but this music will then lift you up, and you'll... Let's just play it.
Thank you.
love that piece. Oh, that's fun. Well, listen, we're going to close off our program now with the South Rampart Street Parade. If you've never been to one of these New Orleans funerals where things start off sort of slow and then they kick up and there's a big celebration later on, you're really missing something. Now, this isn't exactly associated with a funeral. It's not part of that. But it definitely is the type of music that belongs on the other side. Am I right? Okay, good. So we're going to close off at South Rampart Street Parade. So can I get some drum beats back there?